Hello everyone, welcome to NextGen AI Academy. In this video, we are going to learn about Java Constructor. First, we will see the code implementation for easy understanding. Then, we will revisit this slide. Till now, we have learned while creating the instance variable, in order to access these values, what we will do? We will try to create the object instance. The syntax for that is class name, object name equal to new keyword and the class name constructor. I said at that time we will discuss it, that we will do it now. Same way, while accessing the user defined instance method, we followed the same concept. Creating the object instance, with that object we try to access the method. Let's try to create a class default constructor, package name com.nextgen constructor, public static void main finish. First, let me declare an instance variable integer employment id, then string employment name. Here I didn't mention any value. Now, in order to access this instance variable, the syntax we know: class name, object name equal to, it can be any name, new keyword, class name constructor semicolon. Let's try to print and show you. obj dot employment id, obj dot employment name. Okay, let's execute this program. We got the output like this. In this program, we didn't declare any values to these two variables, but still for integer data type we got 0 and for string data type we got null as an output. How we are getting these values? It's all taken care by the default constructor. But here we don't have any specific code for default constructor, but still how we are getting it? It's because even if we are not mentioning any code for default constructor, during runtime the compiler will automatically create the default constructor. I will show it with the code. But before that, let's see some few important points. What is a constructor? Constructor is a special type of method that is used to initialize the object. Every time an object is created using the new keyword. So with the help of new keyword, we will create the object instance. At the time of calling this constructor, memory for the object is allocated, and we know very well how the memory allocation happens in the RAM, which we already discussed in the data types. So this constructor duty is to allocate the memory for each variables. If it is declared, that value will be assigned. If the values are not declared, then what will happen? It will display the default value based on the respective data type. Then we have two types of constructor. One is default constructor, there is no parameter. Another one is parameterized constructor, which will have the parameters. So first, default constructor. For both the constructors, we have to follow certain rules. First rule, constructor name must be same as class name. In this example, what is the class name? The class name is default constructor. Then second point, constructor must have no explicit return type. Then constructor cannot be abstract, static, final or synchronized. So these three rules we have to follow while creating the constructor. Okay, let me show you how to create the default constructor. We know that it should be same as the class name. So like this, then it's a special type of method. That's it. So this is the default constructor. Now I am mentioning this code. By chance, if we miss it, automatically the compiler will create like this in the backend during the execution. So if we execute at that time, it will create like this and allocate the memory. Let me show whether this default constructor is calling or not by displaying some message. Constructor is executed. Now let me execute and show. When execution comes to this line, what will happen? It will automatically come to the default constructor. Then this line will be executed. After that, the memory will be allocated to the both the variables. So whenever we use the new keyword, automatically the default constructor will be called. By chance, if you are not creating this in the backend, it will be created by the compiler. There is one biggest advantage of this default constructor. For example, if you consider iPhone, it may be of any model, iPhone 8 plus or 11 or 12. For all the iPhone, when you switch on, the welcome video will be same. If you consider Nokia phone, it will say connecting people. Exactly what they are doing is, inside the default constructor, if it's an Android mobile, inside this only, they will include the code of welcome screen. Just added one more system like mobile phone logo and welcome message. Let's execute. So when you switch on the phone, constructor will be executed first. Then it will display that welcome screen animation. Then only phone will be started. So this is a real-time application scenario. What we learned now was default constructor. We have another type of a constructor, parameterized constructor. We can also pass some value. I'm going to use same example. So let me create a new class. Parameterized constructor, public static void main finish. Again, same variable. Now we have to create the object instance. So class name, object equal to new class name constructor. Display the output message. Parameterize means here, for example, I want to display like two values, employment ID and employment name. Employment number comma name. I can pass these values to the parameterized constructor. So two values we are going to pass it. So what is the syntax to create the constructor? It should be same as class name. Then like this, let's try to add the parameters, int id, then string name. We can also give the same name, but for a reason I am giving a different name, so that in the next video we will learn this concept. Now this employment id equal to this id, then employment name equal to this particular name. This is the parameterized constructor. Here we are not passing any value, so it's a default constructor. Here we are doing some parameterization, so that's why it's called parameterized constructor. When we execute, you're getting this output. So we are passing some values to the constructor. This concept we use it a lot in the automation. In automation, we try to pass the driver object. At that time, you will understand this concept even much better. That's about the parameterized constructor. In case of interview, if someone asks what is a constructor, just tell it's a special type of a method that is used to initialize the object. Then they will ask what is the keyword you use, it means we will use new keyword. And we have two types of constructor. One is default constructor, another one is parameterized constructor. By chance, if they ask any real-time application, then you can tell that mobile application welcome page is one of the best example where Java constructor is used. Hope you got a good clarity about this topic. That's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Happy learning.